Paul was faithful. Paul began to preach his gospel and bear witness to both small and great. Opposition could not stop him, discourage him, or defeat him. Can I tell you the greatest tragedy that we will see will be all those who stand before Christ. And they will say this: have we not prophesied in your name? Have we not cast out demons in your name? Have we not healed the sick in your name? Maybe some even say this: I went to church week after week. I read my Bible through year after year. I went to prayer meeting. But then Jesus returns these remarks: depart from me, ye who work iniquity. I never knew you. And to know that you were almost persuaded, to know that you were almost saved, but you would not surrender completely to Christ. Many, if not every one of us here today, know the truth. And as our scripture read this morning, King Agrippa heard the truth about Paul's past. King Agrippa heard and knew how God had changed his life. And can I tell every one of us today, once we hear the truth of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the responsibility falls on us even that much more greater. And to me, this is one of the most saddest incidents in the entire Bible. Looking at this story, we can see how God is interested in reaching out to just one person at one moment in history. He reached out to him, but yet that man would not surrender his life to Jesus. Maybe it was because of the love for the world. Maybe it was because of the circumstances of his life. But Paul, who was the great apostle to the Gentiles, he is on trial once again. And God was going to use Paul to bring forth a message as he stood before King Agrippa and Governor Festus. As he would bring forth that message, God was going to use him to give them an opportunity to repent and turn from their ways. And I begin to think about that. It's opportunity after opportunity that pastors get up and they preach the word and they preach the gospel. And yet there are people that will sit in the pews week after week, month after month, year after year, and thinking that they still have plenty of time, thinking that tomorrow will always come, thinking that next week will always come, thinking that next year will always come. But beloved, don't put off tomorrow what you can do today. Don't neglect so great, the Bible says, of salvation. Oh, here it is. Paul is standing before King Agrippa, and Paul is fighting for his very own life. Paul had been arrested, and he was put under protective custody of the Roman army because as a Jew, they were determined that they were going to kill him. But Paul had appealed to Caesar since he was a Roman citizen by birth. And Paul was God's instrument to bring about the preaching of the gospel to King Agrippa. God knew that Agrippa's heart was right and was ready for the gospel, and God determined to give him one last opportunity to hear the message and for him to repent. And I want you to picture this as Paul is standing before the Roman guard. As he is standing there and he is locked up in chains, I can only help to imagine that as King Agrippa and Governor Festus are about to walk in, I can only picture that the Apostle Paul, he is standing there in chains and he begins to pray. He has to begin to pray and say, Holy Spirit, give me the words to say. Everything that you want me to declare, let me begin to speak everything that you want. I want you to picture this as Paul is standing between those Roman guards. He is locked up in chains. I want you to picture this. Do you hear the horns blow? Do you hear the pomp and circumstance take place? And all of of a sudden from the back, the red carpet is rolled out, and here comes Governor Festus first, and then right behind him, here comes King Agrippa, and King Agrippa comes all the way up, and King Agrippa sits on the throne. There's a great celebration because the king is in his place. Oh, great celebration to build King Agrippa's ego, and all of a sudden, court is now in session. And here is the Apostle Paul. The Apostle Paul is locked up in chains. And now they give the Apostle Paul an opportunity to speak. And I find this very interesting because the very first words, that the Apostle begins to speak to old King Agrippa, he says this, "O King Agrippa, I think myself happy today." Oh, what a testimony that is. Have you just ever thought, here the Apostle Paul is. He's about to die. He's locked up in chains. But in the midst of it, he says, "I think myself happy." Oh, I think that's a testimony today. Because some of you in this house, you've been going through the fires of your life. You've been going through difficult circumstances. The care and the storms of this life has overwhelmed you and weighed you down. And I want to encourage you, instead of you just getting the molly crumbs and getting depressed and getting on Prozac, why don't you just say, "Oh God, though my circumstances are bleak, though they are horrible right now, when I look in front of me, I can't even see the light of day, but I will declare, I